essentials to help you survive a nuclear disaster. Let's hope we will never be in a situation that we will need them, but let's pretend we were. Hi, this is Elina, your friendly nuclear physicist, and this is the 10 items I recommend you to have and supply your bunker with to help you survive a nuclear disaster. So let's start from number 10 and work our way upwards to the most essential things one needs to have. So in place number 10, we have important documents. This is not essential for your survival, but it will actually be very helpful once the disaster is over and people are out of their bunkers and trying to get back to their normal life. Essential documents such as your passport, your birth certificate, insurance forms, perhaps some cash, will help you a lot in those first steps. When it comes to number 9, batteries. Batteries are your friends. You want batteries lying around in your bunker, different kinds of batteries for the appliances you might have in your house and that you think you will need to use inside the bunker. Most probably the electricity will be off or will be on and off depending on the extent of the disaster you are facing. Therefore, batteries is a very good thing to have a supply of in your bunker. In number 8, we have power generators. Now, I know power generators is not something that everyone can have in their household. Depending on the size of your house and your bunker, power generators take up a lot of space. But if you can have one, of course it is a much better option than having batteries, because you can actually plug in your devices, you can actually supply yourself and your family with electricity at least for a limited amount of time until the disaster has settled down and you can actually go out of your bunker. So in number 7, we have battery powered devices. And as we discussed in our first video, flashlights is the essential thing you need to have when a nuclear disaster, or if a nuclear disaster was to happen, as well as power battery radios. It is really important to have those in case you need information from the outside world and electricity is not available or internet is not available in order for you to get this information. In number 6, we have tools. It is really important to have a toolbox lying around your bunker in case some of your appliances or devices you have down there actually start malfunctioning or break down, or even furniture or things you might have down there for your comfort. It is therefore really good and it doesn't take up a lot of space to have a couple of screwdrivers or other kind of tools that can help you fix up things until you're ready to go out of the bunker. And now we are approaching the top 5, and we are actually in the 5 essential things you will actually need to survive the nuclear disaster. And in number 5, we have warm clothing. As you might imagine, the bunker conditions would not be ideal. Probably heating will not be available. Therefore, warm clothing, warm blankets, it will be very useful for you to survive, especially if you have to live underground for an extended period of time. So in number 4, we have first aid, and that would be essential to have in case somebody gets hurt or needs some sort of help. And of course, things as band-aids, betadine, cotton buds, or basically an essential kit, first aid kit you can get from a supermarket or a pharmacy, would be good to have around in case something was to happen. So in third place, we have something that you most probably thought would be number 1, and that is food. Food, of course, is essential for a human body to survive, and therefore canned food or dry food would be essential to store in large quantities, or the quantities you think your family would need for at least a couple of days to survive inside a bunker or inside a bomb shelter. And I would recommend really dry foods such as cereal or granola, dried soups that you can just dilute with water and have a quick meal. Tuna, of course, to get in the protein and get in the nutrients you need, and things like canned products like puddings or any kind of other canned beans, for example, can help you very much. You would rather have a variation of different foods, first of all, to not get boring, and also to have all kinds of different nutrients for you and your family to receive in these harsh conditions that you might be experiencing. And now in number 2, essential things you need to have with you to survive a nuclear disaster is water. Of course, water is the number 1 priority for the human body, and we would need plenty of water for us and our loved ones that are stuck in the bunker for survival for at least a couple of days. I would suggest you to have an abundance of water supply for at least a week or 2, because even if you run out of food, you can still survive and maintain yourself just by drinking water. And now the moment you've all been waiting for. Drum roll please. Number one is air ventilation. I know it doesn't really come to mind as a first priority, but it is essential you make sure that your bunker or the bomb shelter you are in is actually properly ventilated. It is crucial for the ventilation to be well and to be clean, first of all, to keep out the radioactive material, dust or smoke that might be outside the bunker, and secondly, for the quality of life in the days that you will be living in there. It is number one priority because if the air is polluted or contaminated or radioactive in the bunker, you will most probably not need any of the 9 items we described previously because the situation will be non-survivable. And those are the top 10 essentials to survive a nuclear disaster brought to you by a nuclear physicist. Hopefully, as I said, we will never need them, but it is really important to have the information nevertheless. It's been Elina, your friendly nuclear physicist, and until next time, see you soon! Hi, this is Elina, your friendly nuclear physicist, and this is the top 10 things I recommend you as a nuclear physicist. It's too many nuclear physicists. Too many nuclear physicists. Like if I say, hi, I'm Elina, your friendly nuclear physicist, I recommend you, I'm a nuclear physicist, you know what I mean?